Here's something. Meeting starts in 2 minutes. You gonna get us set up or what?
We're trying, John.
Try faster.
Just don't know how to do this.
Do these do anything?
I don't know.
Siri, connect us. Alexa.
Hello?
I think client is on WebEx, so maybe we need to be on a PC. Is there a PC in here?
Here we go again with the political correctness.
Personal computer. Boomer.
Right.
Hey, you.
I think I found it, guys. Anyone know the password?
Yeah. A as in Applebee's, B as in Applebee's, P as in pterodactyl, M as in Mary had a little lamb, whose fleece was white as snow.
And we are in.
T-minus 30 seconds till the meeting.
Steve, the invite link.
Oh, I got it right here. It's http://.
Sorry, is it a backslash or a forward?
It's the one that's left to right. Not if we're facing each other, but if you're facing the direction I'm facing.
Wait, we're facing the same direction.
Upper left, lower right.
Upper left, so that sounds like a back.
Two of those.
Can you just forward me that email so I can click on the link?
I have the email still.
Yep. Hang on a second.
Oh, shoot. I gotta log into my email account again. I always forget the password. No, there it is.
It's right there.
I got the email right here, but which one of these 16 links is it?
T-minus negative 3 minutes to the meeting.
Here we go. How to connect a video conference if the two parties have two different systems. Just says good luck.
Can't we connect on our phones?
Is it conference room or conference room guest? Or is it conference room guest 5G? I'm just gonna try this Xfinity one. Anybody know the password?
I might have that.
Guys, I think I got it.
Can you come up here so we can all see?
My phone's on 2%. I have to keep it plugged in.
Does anyone have a longer cable?
I might have one.
Hey, everybody. Sorry we're late. Can you see us?
Uh-oh. My third-party lightning cable is a... Oh, man.
We're gonna lose the deal.
Guys, you do know there's a ClickShare conference room next door, right?
What's that?
Who is that?
I don't know.
Come on. I'll show you. With ClickShare Conference, you just plug this in, click the meeting link, no matter what conference platform you use, and bam, you're connected.
Whoa.
Why is no one there?
Did you know that your meeting was at 1 o'clock Pacific Standard Time?
Ah. Oh.
T-minus 2 hours, 45 minutes until the meeting.
Good afternoon. Thank you for coming. We're very excited to see such a great group here. My name is Dave Fitzgerald. I'm the Vice President for Global Alliances for the Barco Meeting Room Experience team. And we're here today for some very exciting announcements. First up on our agenda today is the Senior Vice President and General Manager of our Enterprise Division, which covers meeting room experience, covers learning experience, and it covers our operator experience. And that's Mr. George Strohmeyer.
Well, thank you all for being here. So then I asked myself, why are we here? And I realized we've been on an innovation journey together with ClickShare over the last several years, as Dave kicked it off earlier as one of the pioneers. And this has been a community that has come together to innovate. And it hasn't just been Barco. It's been you, our channel partners, the industry consultants, our colleagues, of course, at Barco, our customers. Have come together to form a community that decided it's worth your time to come here today and nurture the community and hopefully take us to the next level. So I just thought I'd spend a couple minutes touching on two things, a couple reflections on innovation, because that's what we're here talking about today. And secondly, my own experiences when I joined Barco and got onto the ClickShare innovation train that was already moving when I joined. So on innovation, what is innovation? Peter Drucker was one of the early ones who focused from a management theory and practice on what is innovation and gave this definition. Pretty clear and simple, I think, written over 50 years ago. I think what we would all admit has changed a lot about innovation now is three things. Innovation tends to be a lot more end-to-end. It's not just about a product or a service. It's also about the business model behind it. It's about the marketing that communicates and makes the awareness happen. It's about the process that yields innovation. It's much more of an end-to-end topic that many companies concern themselves with. It's also the need for speed in innovation has become more evident, and all of us are challenged with that. And finally, the sense of scale. Innovation is fun, it's exciting, but in today's workplace, if you don't scale quickly, you never really succeed. And so how do you achieve scale? Something to keep in mind as we go through the afternoon. Peter took it a step further and challenged us with this. He said innovation can be presented as a discipline, capable of being learned and capable of being practiced. I can tell you we're still practicing. So I feel intimidated by the statement. And as we go through the ClickShare innovation journey, you'll see we're still learning and we're still practicing as a community to bring this all together. So ClickShare and my own experience. 4 years ago, about this month, I traveled to Belgium at the invitation of the then CEO. They were putting together an enterprise division, a collection of businesses, and one of them was ClickShare, and he kept talking to me over the phone, encouraging me to come about and see this ClickShare product. And of course, I went to the website, which was horribly slow, and didn't quite get it. But I traveled to Belgium. It was dark and rainy and damp, as it often is in the winter there. And I got introduced to ClickShare. And I have to tell you, I walked away after an intense day there, and I said, wow, they've done it. This thing has fit, form, and function. It really delivers an Apple-like experience. And coming from Silicon Valley, when I told them that at the end of the day, they, of course, were very appreciative. But that was my true sensation. And it was one of the reasons I decided to make the move and become a member of the Barco family. My first day at Barco, a month or so later, was at our Silicon Valley office. I walked in. There were 12 engineers there busy coding. And they were working on the next generation ClickShare. So my takeaway was, first, the company can innovate. Secondly, it's looking around the corner. It's seeing what the trend is. And they were working on a remote conferencing solution, one of two big failures before we reached the offer that we're talking to you about today, which is normal, a couple of deep pivots along the way. The next day, the very next day, I flew to Savannah, Georgia for the Americas Barco sales meeting and got introduced to the Americas team. And as you all know, at a sales meeting, the real conversations take place at the bar at the end of the day. And several Barco salespeople came up to me that night, introduced themselves, and kept telling me, George, this ClickShare thing is amazing. It can go everywhere. This is huge. So that was my introduction to joining the ClickShare journey, innovation journey, in this community, not just at Barco. It's been a wonderful ride over the last 4 years, and it's real pleasure today to bring all of us together to talk about taking that ride a lot further. So what are my calls out to all of us today? First, embrace the moment of this innovation together with you, how you innovate with us, whether you're an ecosystem partner, a channel partner, a consultant, an end user. Secondly, let's take this to the next level as well, create the next commercial success for all of us, and in the end, create great experiences. And finally, let's end the day with you helping us think about what's next after this. Thank you very much.
Thanks, George. Thank you, George. So part of that journey, part of the ClickShare journey, we're going to ask you to take on a new acronym. So you've heard of BYOD. Everybody talks about BYOD. You walk into a meeting room. You use your own device, what you're comfortable with, what's most effective to you, what's what you own licenses for, all on your device. We're going to ask you to engage with us and take a journey with us on a new acronym. And the new acronym is bring your own BYOM. Is it bring your own movie? Is it bring your own map, music, or mobile? Nope. The answer to that question is going to be brought to you today by our Vice President of Meeting Room Experience, Mr. Wim De Bruyne.
Good. Thank you, Dave. Thanks. Hello. Very happy to be here. So, Dave, before I talk about bring your own M, I first want to take a step back in time. Think about meeting experiences more than 7 years ago. 2012, 2013, what were you using? What type of technology were we using? How were we collaborating? let's take a step back in time, right? Well, we actually did a survey in 2013. ClickShare was just about to be launched, or just launched, and we looked at the market, what was happening, how are people using technology. Already at that point in time, we were dreaming about bring your own device. Bring your own device was there. People had their mobile, their laptops. They want to use their own device. But also, paper was still being used. I don't know if you still remember that. I was a consultant at that point in time, had my project meetings, steerco meetings, and I had to bring printed documents to every meeting. Right? Lots of meeting stress, because you wanted to finalize the slides and get it printed all in time, and do not have that stress of connecting your laptop as a consultant to the customer's infrastructure. Now, I raised that problem to my company, say, hey, let's invest in bring your own device technology. What did they do instead? They bought faster printers. So we could just finalize the documents just in time, get them all printed, and be ready for the meeting. So what about bring your own device? Is it still true? Is it happening? So what did we do? We actually took 10 people and hooked them up to a polygraph to see basically in all types of meeting contexts, being decision-making, brainstorming, presentation, how are they feeling? What are the technology challenges that they face, or maybe the engagement challenges, like Adam was saying? So my question is, what's the heartbeat of one of the participants at that point in time? The guy was named, his name was Dave, right? So what was Dave's heartbeat? Dave's heartbeat was 179 beats per minute. Can you imagine? Just because of meeting stress, 179 beats per minute. So poor Dave, and it's not that Dave, it's another one, right, that I took. But let alone the IT manager, Lisa. Lisa had to run to Dave's meeting, try to fix all the issues, use the remote control, whatever, it just did not work. And also our meeting research at that point in time showed that actually IT managers, they run a marathon every year just to fix technology-related problems. Good for their health, but bad for the stress, certainly of this guy. So the question is, how did bring your own device evolve? So we asked four questions to a number of people. The first one is, have meetings changed, right? Secondly, what does it mean in terms of for the remote participants? And what does it mean for their engagement? Because this is really what it's about. It's about engagement, as Adam was saying. And then, of course, what is the future for meetings if we take all of that together? We asked 1,500 people from different geographies, different generations on, okay, what is happening? Can you please educate us? And I'm going to share with you a couple of trends before I unveil the secret about the future of meetings. First trend, the world is turning, of course, into huddles. You all know we've been changing the way how we work. People want to be much more collaborative. They want to work together in huddle spaces. It's about collaboration. It's about creativity. It's about productivity. And we see that 80% of the companies that we actually surveyed, they already have one or more huddle spaces in their, you could say, in their offices. But more than that, people who prefer technology, more than half of them, as you can see, they actually want to work in huddle spaces, not anymore in the traditional types of meeting rooms. They want that flexibility, that collaboration. Next trend, meetings are getting shorter. Who wants shorter meetings out of this audience? Yeah, I would say quite a fair bit of people. Actually, 78% of people want shorter meetings. We all want to be more productive, more collaborative, but we want shorter meetings. Ideally, a meeting takes between 30 to 60 minutes, right? Depending on the number of people, obviously, and the type of activity you're doing. Presentation, brainstorming, decision making. So be more productive, shorter meetings. What's next? It's all about remote. The remote participants, basically, 53% already of meetings today have remote participants. And if we dive a little bit deeper, we actually see that 25% of all meetings actually are only remote. So this is a massive change versus 7-8 years ago in the meeting experience. Now, what does it mean for technology, right? Huddle rooms, shorter meetings, we all love remote, being remote, like Adam was also saying. What does it mean for technology? Basically, video is becoming standard. Actually, we see that 88% of people, basically in huddle rooms, they prefer to do video conferencing. Why? Because, of course, they're colleagues, they are remote, they are on the move, they want to be using video. And 77% of all people we surveyed say video is going to become standard in the meeting rooms, as basically to improve collaboration. Another raise of hands, who uses multiple unified communication and collaboration tools every day? Quite a few, yes. Actually, On average, and I was really surprised by this number, we use 6 different conferencing tools. Over a period of 3 to 6 months, 6 different tools. I think we all have been there, right? It's with partners, with suppliers, even within big companies. Who has only one UC tool within their company? There's always a migration going on from one tool to the other, right? Or branches are not yet on the global standard, right? So multiple UC tools. Now it's time to check in back again with Dave, the end user, right? And Lisa, the IT manager. What type of frictions does it bring? What type of technology challenges? Remote meetings bring a wide range of challenges. As you can see, lost connections, difficulty to hear people during the meeting, poor video quality, unable to basically use one technology from another. How do I get the material? How do I get it shared? Get it through email, and so on, and so on. But the real question is, what does it mean for remote participants? Not only for the people within the meeting room, but also for remotes. Let's have a look. 55% of remote participants basically say, it's really hard for me to concentrate. Right? As a result, most of the people, or at least 43%, say, I'm disengaged, I feel frustrated. And I think most of you probably in remote meetings, if you think about the last 5 to 10 remote meetings you've had, probably you hear a coffee machine, a cat, or a baby crying in the background. People are doing other stuff during remote meetings because they just do not feel engaged. So basically, what does it mean? They want to use their personal technology. I think we've all been there. The remote participant, it's hard to get him into the call. Basically, you say to him, we'll give you a call on your mobile. So you start calling his mobile, put the mobile on the table, put him on speaker, and to get that remote speaker engaged in that way. Or tell him, okay, just quit the call, we'll debrief you later. Right? Fun, right, as a remote participant? So the real question is for us, how do we bring back engagement for remote participants and for the meeting overall? And so there's 3 challenges that we get from our customers. First one, how do I move from one conferencing tool to the next one? I think all of us have this type of calendar or know this. You start with a Zoom meeting, then you have a local meeting within your company or in the meeting room, Skype for Business meeting, Microsoft Teams, and you end the day basically with a WebEx. Now, I'm in one meeting room, my favorite meeting room. How do I get to juggle all these type of tools? It's really difficult for me. Challenge number one. Challenge number two, how do I move from room to room? I finally figured out one meeting room or two, my favorite ones. Then I go to another one, a different type of interface or a different type of meeting room. Because, okay, we standardized the company on Zoom, for instance, but then we still have a Cisco room, we still have an old Polycom room. Just go to that room to do your meeting. But again, as a user, I have to learn the technology. You have to figure out how to use it. Right? So the question we're getting is basically, how can I use the tools and devices that I'm familiar with? Just give me back my freedom to do and use the tools that I know and like. Because I know what's on the right side. I know my laptop. That's what I use every day from the home office or when I'm on the move, just to do my peer-to-peer conferencing calls. So why do I not give back my freedom? So the question is, why can I not simply bring my own meeting? Well, I have the answer, but first a small story. 10 to 15 years ago, I had this old Nokia phone at that point in time, and I had a car, a Volvo. So I walk with my phone into my car, want to connect my phone to my car. So what do? I buy a mobile car kit. It was easy, right, to get into my car, plug in my Nokia, click it in the connector, and I can start using the infrastructure, basically the audio infrastructure of my car. Then 2007, Steve Jobs moment, big speech, innovation and so on, I bought an iPhone, get into my Volvo again. Damn, the connector is different. What do? So luckily, the car industry helped me. They invented wirelessly, I could bring my own device into my car and use the car's audio infrastructure using Bluetooth. So one problem already solved. I want to do the same in meeting rooms, bring my own device and wirelessly connect to the meeting room. Second challenge, okay, I can use my phone now. Google Maps, navigation, history, link to my calendar. I love Google Maps. When I get into my car, this time not anymore a Volvo, but BMW, navigation system is different. All these knobs turning, it's annoying. I just want to click and get going. Right? I want to use the interface that I know from my personal device in my car, whatever the car. So the car industry has now invented, of course, CarPlay and Android Auto. So why do we not can do the same, right? I have my own experience that I know from my laptop. I want to use that in a meeting room. Right? So when you ask me the question, who will give me the freedom that I need, I do know the answer, right? But before I give it to you, I just want to say that I'm very proud today to announce our new product. I've been waiting for it for 1.5 years, right, to be able to announce it. It's only once in a while you can basically announce such a revolutionary product. Last time, I think, was 7 years ago, I think, as Dave and George was saying. So what if I tell you can have truly bring your own meeting? What if you could join wirelessly any type of conference from any type of meeting room using your device? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I present you the new ClickShare Conference. I'm super excited, right? I want to tell you all about it, but it's time for me to shut up. I'm going to invite Gauthier, who is the product manager, right? Gauthier is the product manager for ClickShare Conference, and he will tell you much more about the product, and also a demo will follow. So Gauthier, go ahead. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome, everybody. Now, one of the things that keeps coming back in these researches when we talk to customers, et cetera, is that experience is key. Experience is what drives adoption, it what drives productivity, but also what drives engagement. And that's where it all started for us. How can we enable bring your own meeting in a way that's so intuitive and easy to use that literally anyone can use it? To find a solution for this, we headed out. We went to talk to customers, to end users, and many other people. Yeah? We asked them, how do you like to work? What feels natural in your collaboration? How are you most productive? When at home, behind your desk, or in a meeting room. And with all of this information, we defined a new product, a new experience, which we like to call ClickShare Conference. ClickShare Conference is very easy. You use it or it works in 3 very easy steps. 1, you walk into the meeting room with your laptop. I think that's already pretty easy, right? 2, you plug in a ClickShare button. And as you plug in the ClickShare button, suddenly, all of the meeting room peripherals, the camera, the microphone, the speakers, the display, are made accessible to your device. All you need to do then is to open your tool, your conferencing or collaboration tool, join the meeting, and use the room peripherals to enrich the experience inside the meeting room. No more need to go book a meeting room, to go find that one Zoom meeting room in your company, that one WebEx meeting room. No more touch panel on the table to switch the function of the meeting. I can literally walk into any available meeting space and use any conferencing or collaboration tool into any type of environment. It really is conferencing made simple, wireless, and agnostic. ClickShare Conference allows me to use my device. And this is important because this is a device that I trust because it's managed and secured by my company. It is a device that has all of my files, all of my presentations, all of my meeting notes. It is a device that has all of my tools with my credentials and my contacts. And last but not least, this is a device that I know how to use because I use it at home, I use it behind my desk, and now I can also use it in the meeting room. ClickShare Conference will work with any collaboration or conferencing tool, yeah? Whether it's Teams, Zoom, or WebEx. ClickShare Conference is fully agnostic to the tool you bring with you. And then last, ClickShare Conference can be combined with a wide variety of USB peripherals, meaning that you can build custom solutions to cater the needs and the requirements of your users and the rooms. The combination of offering any peripherals to multitude of tools on your own laptop makes that this solution is 3 times as flexible as any conferencing solution out in the market. Yeah? We like to call it triple agnostic, and it really turns any meeting room into a flexible, multi-purpose meeting room that anyone can use. So how does it work? Well, a lot of the magic is inside the ClickShare button, a new ClickShare button that we designed from the ground up to give you the best user experience and to give these new functionalities to the room. How do you use it? Well, it's very, very simple. You take the button, you plug it into your laptop. At that moment, the LED ring will start filling up, and within a matter of seconds, the entire room is ready to use. What you then see is that in the background, by plugging in the button, all of the room's peripherals are made available to the laptop to be used inside of your tools. The fact of having a button makes that the user doesn't need to install any drivers, doesn't need to connect to the room or configure their settings. Everyone can walk into the room, plug in the button, and get started in an instant, whether you're an employee, a visitor, or even a guest. The fact that we have a button also makes that we have a point-to-point direct connection between the laptop and the peripheral. It means that we can bring high-quality and low-latency audio to anyone, perfect for any type of meeting. And last but not least, the new ClickShare button has a new secondary button, which brings you conferencing and collaboration applications within the ClickShare app. A ClickShare app, which is going to guide you and help you, and together with the button, is going to give you an enriched experience inside of the meeting room. With this, we have reinvented, but we have also built on what was there to offer the best user experience available in the market. Now, the user experience is one big thing that ClickShare is known for. Another thing that doesn't get mentioned enough is that ClickShare is an enterprise-grade solution. It is a solution which is meant to sit on your network, where it can be configured, updated, and managed remotely. But as it sits on the network, it can also be combined with other tools, such as Overture. ClickShare is a product which is secure by design, and we have the ISO 27K certification to prove it. What does it mean? It means that Barco has the knowledge and the processes in place to build and maintain secure products. It means that Barco knows how to act in case vulnerabilities are detected or flaws are disclosed. It also means that we handle all of the data from the customers, from the end users, with the utmost care. ClickShare can be managed centrally with the XMS platform, a platform which can be deployed locally or in the cloud, meaning it is fit for any type of company. Inside XMS Cloud, you'll find additional insights so that you can see how users use the room, which functions they use or do not use, so that you can build the best workspaces for your employees. And last, ClickShare Conference comes with a smart care service package included, meaning that the buyer or you doesn't have to worry about a thing for the entire lifetime of the product. And with this, I am now very excited to introduce to you the new ClickShare Conference.
Working together. It's how we've always reached our best ideas. But today, we're doing it remotely, flexibly, making it harder for people to click. Enter wireless conferencing with the conferencing button and wireless collaboration with the quick button and collaboration app. You bring your own meeting on any laptop across any UC platform, seamlessly and intuitively share ideas, whether in a huddle space, boardroom, or not in the room at all. Hey, what's up? ClickShare works with your existing room setup, instantly connecting your screen, speakers,
hello, can you hear me?
And microphone. Yeah, we can hear you. It's IT friendly too. With the Insight module, you can better understand behavior to improve your workspace. And don't worry, all communications are secure and encrypted. It's got everything you need to get teams collaborating naturally and more effectively. ClickShare. Great things happen when people click.
Pretty exciting, right? I would now like to invite you to the table, to the meeting room table, for the very first public ClickShare conference demonstration with my colleague, Michael van der Heeren, Product Management Director of Meeting Experience. Hi, hey, Michael.
Welcome, Guti.
Thank you.
So welcome into our meeting room setup that you can see here. We have a beautiful view over the skyline of New York, basically. For your information, what you can see over there on the left side is my laptop view, so you can follow a little bit the experience I have here as well. On the right side, you have a camera view of what we're doing here actually at the table. So we're in the meeting room here, and it's time to do our first public ClickShare conference call, basically. Now, it's pretty easy. You plug in the ClickShare button, as I did here, and what I can do is known by everyone, of course. I can just share my presentation on the screen. That's what we're all used to. That's what you know of ClickShare. Now, ClickShare Conference can, of course, do a lot more than just that. So let me open to start with Microsoft Teams. And it seems that I have here a few calls scheduled, and one of these calls is a Microsoft Teams call that I have with one of my colleagues. So let's join this Microsoft Teams call. That's the first thing we want to do here. So I press the join button within Teams, And the magic already starts. You immediately see that the camera of the room is popping up. We're using the speakers of the room and the microphone of the room. All of this happening to the ClickShare button that we have here. So let's join the call, Gauthier.
Yes.
We press join now. And there we go.
And there we go.
Hey, Hans.
Hey.
Hey, Michael, you look excited.
Yes, we are absolutely excited. So,
hey, Michael. Hi, Gauthier.
Who's there?
It seems on the other end there is someone else as well. So could you guys maybe use ClickShare Conference as well? So Hans is now plugging in the ClickShare button. And we'll see that the audio will drop for a second, and it will change to the meeting room audio and camera. So here it goes.
Oh, hey, Frederick.
Hey, Hans. Hey, Frederick. How are you guys? Good? So let's see. We can also share some slides from this end if we want to, or a PowerPoint or my desktop. Any of these possibilities is basically possible. So, oh, we're going back to his view. So this was our first call that we did with Microsoft Teams, basically. And this is the way and the easiness of ClickShare Conference. So what it basically does, it enables people to click with one another. They can now hear and see each other very well through this wireless conferencing capability that is in the ClickShare button. So guys, thank you very much for the call.
See you.
So this was Microsoft Teams, and as we said, it's truly agnostic. It works with any device, whether it's a Windows or a Mac. Doesn't really matter. It works with any USB peripheral. So whether this it's this Logitech Rally Plus setup or a Meetup or any other conferencing peripheral that's USB, you just plug it into the ClickShare and you're able to do that. And it also works with any conferencing platform. Now, not just Teams, as I just showed here. So this call was pre-scheduled. It was in Teams. So why not do yet another call? So for that, I will go to Zoom, basically. I'm opening up Zoom here. And instead of having a pre-scheduled call, I just go into my contacts, and I have here Antenna. And so let's call maybe Antenna and see if we can discuss some other things. There we go. Immediately, again, you see that the room is popping up. We have the camera being used, and we have the microphone and the speakers of the room as well. Hey, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine.
So maybe let's ask Antenna what the view on her side actually is. So you can see at the top, this is what we expect to see, of course. So Antenna, what are you seeing basically on your end?
Well, I can see both of you clearly. I can see there you have a bit, yeah, pretty big crowd behind you. Well, audio is running well as well. So I can see everything.
So we're pretty excited about launching this product indeed. And you can see whether it is this platform or any other platform, I can basically share whatever content that you want. It makes it pretty easy. There's also, of course, the quick button functionality, which I could use to share something remotely to other participants as well. So that makes it a possibility to share to anyone that you want to have. So I could go in Zoom and share content like I'm used to if I want to, even a whiteboard, share another application. All of these things are possible because, again, I'm using my tools and I bring my own conference with me. Makes it easy, makes it very simple. And the only thing you do is basically by plugging in the ClickShare button, you have the capability of using all the capabilities of the room. Whatever room it is, whatever platform it is, whatever capability you're bringing in yourself. Antenna, thank you very much for the call. We were very happy doing this.
Bye-bye.
All right.
Bye.
So let's end this call as well. So that gives you an idea of how simple ClickShare Conference basically is. It is all driven by this button. What we did was basically we had a first call which was pre-scheduled in Microsoft Teams, simply joined it, doesn't really matter. By plugging in the button, we were able to use the room camera, the room speakers, the room microphone. We're able to share in Microsoft Teams and any other application just like we want to and just like we're used to from doing at our desk or somewhere else in a meeting room. And then finally, we did another demonstration and called Antenna, who is remote, not in a meeting room anywhere close by here. And we could also call her. It was on a different platform, Zoom. We could as well use WebEx, BlueJeans, or any of the other platforms and do exactly the same thing. It isn't limited. You don't need a license within your room to do this. It makes it very simple.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, I think so too. Thank you very much. That was a demo.
So, great job, Michael Gauthier and team, and the distant participants. Thank you very much. So part of our message, of course, is we have an agnostic approach, and it's certainly, we talked about the UC platforms, we talked about whatever device you bring, and then the third element that Michael just touched upon was the camera speaker mic that's in the room. So certainly we need to be compatible with the major players on that in that space and that are out in the market today. And today we are fortunate enough to bring the company that's got the largest share in that space, Logitech. We're very pleased to be able to have Scott Wharton, their general manager, here to speak with us and share some of his thoughts and ideas and how we're partnering together. Scott?
Great. Thanks, Dave. Good afternoon, everybody. So I'm sure many of you are familiar with Logitech. You know that we make mice and keyboards, probably what you're most familiar with. Some of you are probably also familiar that we make webcams. How many of you have ever used a webcam in your life? Yeah, we're doing pretty well in that space. I think we have almost 96% market share, so okay. I don't know who the other 4% of the people are, but we'll give them a pass. So in addition to webcams, we've come a long way in the video space, and we not only make webcams now, to a whole variety of video conferencing gear, everywhere from the desktop to now in the conference room. And part of what we've done is gone from creating webcams to individual conference room units to really room systems for everything you need in a room. So we focus with cloud partners like Microsoft, Zoom, and Google, and others to create systems for them. And then we've tried to make it really simple. So all you need to know is, do you have a small, medium, or large room? And you basically get one of these kits, and you could put it into any room. And so not only can you get a small, medium, and large room, but you can also get it anywhere around the world. So part of our success, like Barco, is really focusing on the enterprise. So we can serve people in over 100 countries worldwide and work with thousands of resellers around the world to get video conferencing gear. So partly it's about the user experience, as Vim said. It's about making things easy. It's about making things cost effective and getting enterprise-grade systems anywhere around the world. And of course, the success of that, here are some of our customers that we have that have deployed video all around the world. So just a couple of things. As Dave said, you probably would be surprised, but in a very short period, Logitech's gone from being an early entrant in this space to being the global market leader. So this is a slide from Synergy Research that shows video conferencing and units. So you can see that we're not only are we the biggest in this space, but we're actually the biggest in the world, more than our other two competitors combined now in a very short period of time. If you just take the USB unit, so if you take out the legacy H323 systems, you can see that we also sell about 2 out of every 3 USB units out there. So we've had a lot of success in a very short period, and I think it's part of why we're excited to work with Barco, is take the success we've had with customers and apply it to the new ClickShare conference. So let's talk a little bit about Logitech and Barco and what we're doing together. So part of what we're doing is the same simple idea of 3 rooms, small, medium, and large, and taking the combination of Logitech USB peripherals, video conferencing, and applying it with ClickShare Conference. So you can go into a small room, medium room, even a large room, up to a boardroom, and you can have that same experience that you just saw in a demo with Bring Your Own Meeting and apply it to a meeting space of any size. In fact, the demo here was shown with our Rally Plus system, so that can scale up to larger rooms. And if you're interested, we have a meetup which showed in some of the slides up there in the back, where I think some of the Barco people are looking in remotely. So what's exciting about this new solution is now you can take these solutions that are tied to Google, Microsoft, and Zoom, where if you want, you can have a dedicated system. Or if you want to bring your own meeting and you really want to be untethered to any meeting solution at all, now you have the new Barco ClickShare Conference. That's a great new alternative for bring your own meeting, where you could just work with anyone in any space at any time. So, I just want to sum up. I would say that I'm really honored to be here, and we've had this great relationship with Barco. We've been working together over the number of years, and there's just so many similarities between the company and cultures in terms of generating the same user experience or great user experience, to working around the globe, to taking what we do well, taking video conferencing and really making it easy to use and accessible, and democratizing it everywhere, and really doing the same thing with Barco, but now extending it to these new spaces where you don't need to be tied to any one technology. You can use anything you want with the same experience that you're used to using on your laptop. So we're super excited about this partnership. We know that you are going to be too, and we look forward to launching it and talking to you more about it. So thank you very much.
Thanks, Scott. Thanks. Thank you so much for coming today. We had an exciting agenda with an unbelievable demo. We appreciate everybody's attendance here. And if you need more information on the Barco ClickShare Conference, please look for us at www.barco.com/clickshare. Thank you.
It's true, though. You can host your conferences in a ClickShare room just as fast as you can plug in a ClickShare button and click on the meeting link that you got from whoever, wherever, from whatever meeting platform they use. BlueJeans, GoToMeeting, Zoom, Teams.
It truly is BYOM. It's bring your own meeting and host a video conference from your own laptop.
Would that not be BYOMAHYOMFYOL?
Maybe. I don't know.
Point is, you should go to barco.com/clickshare.
Cheers.
Bring all of your conferences into Barco ClickShare Conference Room and connect instantly, no matter the conferencing platform. Learn more at barco.com/clickshare.